Hello everyone, welcome back. So in this presentation, we are going to study about class 3 enzymes, that is hydrolases. So there are more than 200 hydrolases are present. So as the name suggests, they catalyze cleavage of a covalent bond using water. So these covalent bonds may be CO, that is carbon oxygen or ether bond, or CN amide bond, or peptide bond CONH, or carbon carbon bond. So like this, carbon sulfur, carbon phosphate, so many bonds, the covalent bonds can be broken down by enzyme hydrolases by addition of water. So the overview of this reaction, suppose this is a molecule, AB is a molecule, by adding water with the help of enzyme hydrolase, so this molecule can be cleaved. So this molecule will become now, and we will get another molecule with B. This is the overview of enzyme catalyzed reactions by hydrolases. As I mentioned, they catalyze breakdown of covalent bonds. So according to these bonds, they are subclassified into different category. So this hydrolases is EC3, that is enzyme class 3. Now they are subclassified on the basis of their action on functional groups. So they can break ester bond. So now this will become EC3-1. The subclass will be 1. Those hydrolases which break ester bond, they are commonly known as esterases. The example for esterases are, again there is subclassification, they may be phosphatases, lipases, the enzyme which is responsible for digestion of triglycerides, and also lipoprotein lipase. There are different isoenzymes of lipases. Nucleic acids, that is nucleases, they are also esterases, and also phosphodiesterase. So all these are hydrolases, and their target functional group is ester bond. So they belong to enzyme commission number 3-1 series. And these hydrolases can also break bonds between sugars. They can break glycosidic bond. So they are commonly known as glycosidases. Also in DNA, they are known as glycosylases. So these glycosidases, they break down carbohydrates. They are also hydrolases. And also in case of DNA, they are called DNA glycosylases or glycosylases. So they belong to enzyme commission 3-2, subclassification 2. These hydrolases can break ether bond like CO. So they are EC, enzyme class 3 and subclass 3. Most important hydrolases are EC3-4. So they can attack on peptide bonds, that is CONH, and they are commonly known as proteases or peptidases. So one thing you need to remember, all digestive enzymes, whether it is carbohydrate, lipid, protein, they are belong to hydrolases, the class 3 enzymes. And these hydrolases can break even amide bond. This is other than peptide bond. Peptide bond also partially amide bond, CN, but it has got C double bond ONH, that is peptide bond. If it is CN, see, other than peptide bond, we call amide bond, and then we can call them as amidases. So they belong to enzyme commission or enzyme class 3 and the subclass 5. So like this, there are 12 subclasses. So I am not going to give all those. Some important hydrolases are esterases. They are very important. Even for the carbohydrate digestion, we require glycosidases, peptidases or proteases for protein metabolism. Even esterases, in that we have lipases, phospholipase, cholesterol, esterase and lipase. All these are lipid digestive enzymes. So these are the subclassification of hydrolases. So if you want to remember example, you can write any digestive enzymes like trypsin, chymotrypsin, pepsin, lipase, amylase, all these enzymes are hydrolases. It's very easy to remember example for hydrolases. So I'll be explaining by giving one example for the action of hydrolase enzyme. So I'm taking an example of lactase. So the enzyme commission number, it belongs to class 3 and the subclass 2 and subclass 1, and it is the 23rd enzyme in this enzyme commission or enzyme code number 321 series. The other name for lactase is beta galactosidase. So that means this enzyme usually helps in digestion of sugar present in the milk. So lactose, that is, it is a disaccharide made up of beta galactose and alpha glucose, beta D galactose and alpha D glucose. So this is actually lactose. So this lactose, with the help of enzyme lactase, by adding water, it will give beta galactose and alpha glucose. So I can explain this reaction with the help of structure. You can see this is the structure of lactose. So here this molecule is galactose, whereas this one is glucose. So how to differentiate between glucose and galactose? You can watch my videos on carbohydrates chemistry, where I have explained about isomers. So this galactose and glucose are epimers with respect to carbon number 1. So you can see this is glucose, and if you want to name, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and this is 6 carbon. Similarly for galactose, this will be 1. In the 4th carbon atom of glucose and galactose, so there is interchange between OH and H. So they are epimers with respect to carbon number 4. So this lactose, with the help of enzyme lactase, by adding water, so this particular bond is called glycosidic bond, and this glycosidic bond is beta 1,4 glycosidic bond. Now this lactase enzyme going to break this lactose into galactose and glucose. Now you can see here, so this will become our galactose and this is our glucose. So here you can see clearly, this is carbon number 4 and this is carbon number 4. So the only difference between glucose and galactose in the carbon number 4, they are epimers. So you can see here, the galactose is beta galactose. Why? Because OH group in the anomeric carbon atom, that is carbon number 1, above the plane. Whereas glucose, you can see it is alpha glucose, because in the anomeric carbon atom, the first carbon, OH group is below the plane. So we have galactose and glucose. So this is the explanation for hydrolases. Thanks for watching.